Hello friends, welcome to your very own channel Sony Singh Physics. In this video, I am going to share with you some very important tips for how to prepare for your upcoming examination. Let's see that. This video contains what will be tested in your physics examination, how to read your exam questions, how to answer questions, and how to plan your physics revision. So we'll see that. First is what will be tested. Your knowledge, what you remember, and understanding how you use what you know and apply it to unfamiliar situations. How you handle information and solve problems. Then your use of experimental skills. So these things will be tested in your physics examination. Then next is reading the questions. What should be taken care when you read a question? You must read and understand the introductory sentences above the diagram first before trying to answer the questions. It is very easy when presented with a diagram question to look at the diagram and then try to answer the question. So here I am going to show you one sample question that what is the meaning of statement above the diagram. This is a sample question, and as you can see, there is a statement above the diagram, so that is called introductory statement. If there are 3 marks available for a calculation, 2 of the 3 marks are for showing your working. If a question states accurately mark or accurately draw, we expect. For example, if you have to mark center of gravity, then you have to be carefully positioned and line to be drawn with care using a ruler. When reading the questions, decide which area of physics you are being asked about. Do not just look at a few words, as you may then misunderstand the question. For example, a question that mentions heat radiation is not about radioactivity just because the word radiation is seen. If you are asked for a convection current diagram, do not draw a circuit just because the word current is in the question. Answering the questions. Here are some examples that show the type of understanding that is required to answer questions successfully. You must understand the turning effect of a force, and that is called the moment of the force. You must be clear about the names given in the types of energy and use them appropriately. You should know the circuit symbols required for use in describing electrical circuits. The symbol for a fuse is often not known, and the symbols for a thermistor and a variable resistor are commonly confused with each other. So we have to take care about it. We must know that how to connect a voltmeter in parallel with the component across which you are measuring the potential difference. You must have a clear understanding of electromagnetic induction. For example, you must know that when a magnet is moved in or out of a solenoid that is part of a circuit, the current will be induced. It is the movement of the magnet in the solenoid that causes the current, as its magnetic field lines cut the coil. For paper 5 and 6, you will take one of these papers that test practical physics. There are some particular points that are relevant to answering the question here. When plotting a graph, it is important to choose the scale so that the plots occupy more than half of the graph grid. Careless rust graph plotting can lose several marks. You should always use a sharp pencil and plot small, neat, accurately placed crosses. Then draw a neat, thin, best fit line. You should understand that if y is proportional to x, then the graph will be a straight line through the origin. Diagram should be drawn with care using a sharp pencil. Column headings in tables of readings must be headed with the quantity and unit as in these examples. Final answer should be given to 2 or 3 significant figures. You should understand the significance of wording such as within the limits of experimental accuracy. If you are asked to justify a statement, then you should use the data to explain your answer, not just theoretical explanation. Plan for your physics examination, and student of class 10 belongs to any syllabus can use this plan. And as you can see, there are four columns: first, content topic; second, you should be able to; third, these are the main thing, red, amber and green colors; and the fourth column contain comment. So first topic means there will be core and extended, and extended topics will be in different color. It will be in gray or purple color. Then second column will contain your syllabus, and third is the main thing which I will discuss in our next video. And in comment, you can have any additional point which you want to use for your revision. So next I will show you example for your revision plan, and I have taken from the topic motion, forces and energy. And as you can see, there are two colors, white and purple. Then white color will be for core, and then purple will be for extended students. And then these are red, amber and green columns, and then comment section. So how to use this plan, I am going to share with you in detail in my next video. Thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to your very own channel, Sony Singh Physics. Thank you.